consider myself to be an African writer, and I don't consider that to be like a pejorative or limiting in any way.
Yeah.
And I feel that like it's only limiting if people bring a limiting perspective to it. And so if you're somebody who thinks African literature is all about war and starvation and blah blah blah, then like that's your problem. Like I'm not gonna change the way I identify it because of that.
It's in your skin.
Anything about how someone's going to interpret,
yeah,
like who I am or my own perspective, and so all I can control is the labels that I'm comfortable with. I'm comfortable with a black writer. I'm comfortable being an African writer. I'm comfortable being a Nigerian writer. I'm comfortable being a woman writer. Like, these are all things that I am, and so if somebody wants to call me any one of those things, I'm fine with it. It isn't as neat as saying that, oh, writing these powerful, like, these two fearless characters helped me become fearless, because that's not the case. But imagining sort of a different way that things can be is always illuminating,
yeah.
Right? And imagining somebody making a choice that you would not make is always very illuminating, and getting into that character's head and understanding, you know, empathetically how and why they are doing the things that they're doing.